This week we cover Varda Space's W-2 spacecraft, soon to be landing in Australia. Secondly, we have video from InnoSpace on their tank tests. And lastly, we cover updates from Firefly and their Blue Ghost moon lander. Okay, let's get started. Varda's W-2 spacecraft landing at Koonibba test range soon. Varda Space's W-2 spacecraft launched on the SpaceX Transporter 12 mission in mid-January and is expected to land in Australia at the Koonibba test range no earlier than the 21st of February 2025. This will be Australia's first ever commercial spacecraft re-entry, closely followed, we hope, by the launch of Gilmour Space's Eris-1 vehicle from Queensland in mid-March of this year. Southern Launch, the first licensed space launch facility in Australia, was responsible for securing all required approvals for the mission. They are also providing an end-to-end service for managing the re-entry process and retrieval of the capsule from the Australian desert once it lands back on Earth. Varda Space will be using the Southern Launch range for the next three W-Series missions. Their first mission landed in the Utah desert in the US, but suffered from long delays acquiring a landing license from the FAA. The W-2 capsule, designed for in-space manufacturing, also carries payloads from the US Air Force and NASA's Ames Research Center. The Australian government granted return authorization for the mission in October 2024, making it the first domestically returning spacecraft approved under a new space law enacted in 2018. In related news, Rocket Lab, which manufactures the satellite bus for Varda's re-entry capsule, has delivered the third spacecraft, W-3, to Varda Space. Varda develops the 120-kilo re-entry capsule, but relies on Rocket Lab's Pioneer satellite platform to save time. This platform provides essential components, including propulsion, flight software, avionics, reaction wheels, star trackers, separation systems, solar panels, radios, and tanks. Rocket Lab is executing quickly, delivering the W-3 platform, while W-2 is still actively operating in space. This rapid manufacturing helps increase the operational cadence for Varda Space and move space manufacturing closer to being commercially viable. The W-3 spacecraft is scheduled to launch in March from Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. Okay, on to our second story this week. InnoSpace, Handbit Nano, second stage propellant tank test. A few days ago, InnoSpace, the South Korean launch provider, tested propellant tanks for their Handbit Nano orbital rocket. As you can see from the video, the tank is coated with frost, as the propellant inside the tank is very cold. The tank is designed to hold propellant at 6 bar, but withstood pressures of 7.5 bar, demonstrating outstanding performance. Automated fiber placement technology was used in the manufacturing of this tank. This carbon composite tank is much lighter than an equivalent aluminium tank would be. Typically, these composite tanks can be between 20 to 40% lighter than metal tanks. InnoSpace continues to make progress and should be launching their first Handbit Nano rocket from Brazil later this year. We'll keep you informed when we get more news about their launch progress. Okay, on to our final story for this week. Firefly Updates. We have a few updates from Firefly Aerospace. Firefly was recently awarded a $21 million contract from the US Space Force for Victus Sol, a tactically responsive space mission. These missions demand rapid response, with Firefly expected to launch within just 24 hours of receiving the payloads. Meanwhile, Firefly's Blue Ghost continues on its journey to the moon. After a month-long transit from cislunar space, the lander successfully executed a critical 4-minute lunar orbit insertion burn on Thursday, marking the longest and most challenging burn yet for its main engine and reaction control system thrusters. This milestone brings Blue Ghost closer to attempting landing in the Mercurism region on the near side of the moon. Over the next 16 days, the lander will perform additional maneuvers to position itself from an elliptical to a circular orbit around the moon. Blue Ghost Mission 1 is set to touch down on Sunday, the 2nd of March, at 3:45 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. During the orbit insertion burn, the lander captured a stunning image of the moon's south pole. We also have a time-lapse video from Firefly, taken from on board the Blue Ghost lander. These images were captured on Thursday, the 13th of February, and converted into a video. Okay, that wraps up this week's space news. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.